Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and I have brought to you very interesting questions in this video. All the questions can be of use if you are an aspirant of RBI SEBI and NABARD. So on that note, let's quickly begin this video. But before that, if you are a newcomer here, then let me inform you that you have the Telegram channel where you can download the PDF of this session, and the Telegram channel is in description below. The link of that channel is in description below. Okay, so here we have the first question. Which state has launched the Dhanvantri generic medical store scheme? So you have West Bengal, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh in the options, out of which Chhattisgarh is the right answer. So basically, under this scheme, medical stores will be established across the state to provide the medicines at a very low cost to the citizens, because we know that in many states and in overall India, if we want to see it, take the larger picture in our mind, then in overall India, we have a huge out-of-pocket expenditure towards our health, okay? So health services are quite expensive when it comes to the tertiary and secondary health care, okay? However, this has nothing to do with this scheme. I'm just stating a basic observation. But as far as this scheme is concerned, you need to know that medicines will be provided to the citizens at a lower price in comparison to the price that the citizens pay at the general medical stores, okay? So this is a step towards reducing the out-of-pocket expenditure of the citizens of the state. Can you guys tell me that which central scheme, central government scheme, is doing the same thing at the national level? Okay, this is your question. Do mention it in the comment section, so that I get to know how much are you prepared in your government schemes. As far as this news is concerned, so let me tell you that while launching this scheme, the Chief Minister Bhupesh Baghel inaugurated 84 Dhanvantri medical stores. And under the scheme, this I have already told you, that low and affordable rates will be charged from the customers for medicine. And the purpose is to increase the universal health coverage. Now, not only this scheme, there are 2 to 3 other healthcare schemes that are already in place in Chhattisgarh that aim to increase the universal health coverage. And my friends, these schemes are not very old schemes. Okay. So the one scheme is Chief Minister Heart Bazaar Clinic scheme, Chief Minister Urban Slum Health scheme. So both of these schemes aim to provide the health services at the remotest areas of the state. Now, apart from this, there is one more scheme that I am recalling right now, and that scheme is Dai Didi Clinic scheme. Now, under this scheme of the state, the clinics are established only for the women and adolescent girls in order to tackle their healthcare problems, okay? So these are the health schemes of Chhattisgarh government. Okay, which country has been added to the FATF grey list in October 2021? Jordan, Mali, Lebanon, both A and B, both B and C. Okay, so whenever we hear about FATF, it is usually in the context of Pakistan, because news headlines are such that we only get to see Pakistan in the FATF grey list, but this is not the complete picture. There are a lot of countries in the grey list of the FATF, and right now in the month of October, a total number of 3 countries have been added: Jordan, Mali and Turkey. Now, Turkey's addition to this list is very highlighted in the news, because Turkey is considered as a very important ally for Pakistan, for Pakistan's finances, and right now the country has also been added into the grey list. Okay. Now, the implication of being added into the grey list is that from now onwards, FATF would monitor the finances, would monitor the money laundering or the terror financing in this country very strictly. So that is the implication. So if Pakistan was asking for money from Turkey for terror funding or money laundering, then obviously it would come under the surveillance of FATF. So that's why, that's the whole relationship behind Turkey and Pakistan, and that's the whole thing, the whole controversy in news. We don't have to go into the controversy. Now, this is the list of October 2021. So as you can see that there are many countries in the list. Okay, so द लिस्ट इज ऑफिशियली नोन एज ज्यूरिस्डिक्शंस विद स्ट्रेटेजिक डेफिशिएंसीज. ओके, एंड आफ्टर गेटिंग इनटू दिस लिस्ट बेसिकली द मीनिंग और द इम्प्लीकेशन इज दैट एफएटीएफ वुड नाउ इंक्रीज इट्स मॉनिटरिंग ऑन द कंट्री. सो दैट इज द बेसिक इम्प्लीकेशन ऑफ बींग एडेड इनटू द ग्रे लिस्ट ऑफ एफएटीएफ. ओके, नाउ डू रिमेंबर दैट in June 2021 when the list was updated last time, only Mauritius was out of this list, but now Botswana has also come out of this list. Okay, so Botswana has also come out of the gray list. So do remember this fact as well. This can also be asked in your exam. Now let's discuss some facts about FATF itself. So it was established in 1989 by G7. It is the global money laundering and terror financing वॉचडॉग, मॉनिटर करता है. 37 कंट्रीज आर मेंबर्स, 2 आर रीजनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, यूरोपियन कमीशन एंड गल्फ कोऑपरेशन काउंसिल आर द ऑब्जर्वर्स और ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस विच आर मेंबर्स ऑफ एफएटीएफ. इंडोनेशिया इज द ओनली ऑब्जर्वर नेशन ऑफ एफएटीएफ. एफएटीएफ वर्क्स इन ओवर 200 ज्यूरिसडिक्शंस. ओके, सो लेट मी क्लैरिफाई हियर दैट मेंबर कंट्रीज आर लिमिटेड. Only 39 are members out of 39, 2 are organizations. Okay, but the countries where FATF monitors terror funding and money laundering activities are in total more than 200. Okay, so for example, if Colombia, for example, is not a part of FATF, is not a member of FATF, it does not imply that FATF would not monitor the activities being done in Colombia. Okay, so by jurisdiction, it means the area of operation of FATF is in more than 200 jurisdictions. Okay, and how does FATF monitor the activities of these many countries? By establishing its own FATF regional bodies. Okay, FATF style regional bodies. The headquarters or the secretariat of FATF is in OECD headquarters in Paris. The president at present is Markus Player, who is from Germany. So that was all about the FATF. When did Barbados get its independence from Britain? Okay, so now I guess that you would be thinking ki ye kahan se question aa gaya, ab kya world history bhi padhni padegi RBI nikalne ke liye. So let me say, my friends, yes or no, both are the answer of this क्वेश्चन. पढ़नी भी पड़ेगी और नहीं भी पढ़नी पड़ेगी. द रीजन दिस क्वेश्चन इज हियर बिकॉज द बार्बाडोस हैज अनाउंस्ड टू बिकम अ रिपब्लिक, दैट इज द न्यूज. एंड बिकॉज इट हैज अनाउंस्ड टू बिकम अ रिपब्लिक, इट हैज अपॉइंटेड इट्स फर्स्ट प्रेसिडेंट ऑल्सो, नॉट अपॉइंटेड, बेसिकली इलेक्टेड द फर्स्ट प्रेसिडेंट ऑल्सो. सो दैट वॉज द न्यूज एंड फ्रॉम देयर दिस क्वेश्चन हैज स्प्रंग अप. ओके, सो लेट मी टेल यू द आंसर इज 1966. सो इन 1966 This Barbados got its independence from British rule, which started in the year 1625. So it's a really long time period after which Barbados got its independence. Now let's have a look into the news itself. So I have already told you that Barbados has announced to become a republic. Although it got its independence way back in 1966, still it was under the rule of British Queen Elizabeth II, and now they have decided that they will have their own government, own elected president, and they have they have rejected the British colonial legacy in their own country. That is why this is important that they have announced to become a republic, and this announcement has not been made recently. It was announced in 2020 only that yes, we will be becoming a republic. Now they have elected their president, and that president is Dame Sandra Mason. So she would be the first president of Barbados. Do remember. So until now, she was serving or has been serving as the Governor General since 2018, and she is the first woman to serve in the Barbados Court of Appeals, first woman president of Barbados as well. So do remember that as well. Next is Barbados is also referred to as the Little England. Pay attention to this term. This can also become a question. Which Caribbean island country, which is also known as the Little England, has announced to become a republic in October 2021? This could become a direct question. then you should be aware of this fact that Little England is called, basically Barbados is known as the Little England. Okay, so these dates I have already told you. Okay, on November 13, the elected president will take oath. Okay, so this day is the Independence Day of this country. So do remember this as well, that November 30 is the Independence Day of Barbados. Total population is less than 3 lakhs. Currency is dollar, capital is Bridgetown. Do remember. Now this is the exact location between US and between North America and South America. We have the Caribbean islands, and this is the zoomed picture of the Caribbean islands. This is the location. This is Barbados. Okay. So guys, if you can see here, this place is very important. Cartagena, which is a place in Colombia, a very important protocol. Is with the name of Cartagena. Cartagena protocol is related to which issue? This is your question that you have to mention in the comment section below. Okay, so next question is about an index. What is India's rank in the Rule of Law Index 2021? The ranking is 79th. World Justice Project has released this report. 139 countries are the members of, basically not the members, the countries that have been assessed in this index. Top is Denmark, bottom is Venezuela. Parameters are these, but we will be discussing each and every parameter in detail when we will look into the rankings on each parameter. Okay, so yes, you have heard it right. Each and every parameter has a separate ranking as well. So these are the sub indices, you can see. Now, India's specific facts are that India's rank is 79th, and do remember the score of India 0.50. India's rank has reduced by 3 positions from the last edition. In South Asia, India's rank is 3rd out of the 6 countries that have been assessed. So you can clearly see Nepal and Sri Lanka are better in terms of law and order from India. Now here we have the parameters. Constraints on government power. Denmark is the top, India is at the 52nd rank. Absence of corruption. Denmark is again top, 95th is India's rank. Open government. Norway is first, India's rank is 14th. Fundamental rights. Denmark is first, India's rank is 93rd. You can see fundamental right is the basic backbone of a democracy, and still we are standing at the 93rd position even when we are the largest democracy of the world. So this is paradoxic, this is basically ironical in nature. Order and security. Ireland first, India is at 121st rank. Order security bahut hi weak hai yahan ki. Regulatory enforcement. Denmark is first, 78th is India. Civil justice, Denmark first, 110th is India's rank. Criminal justice, Norway first, 86th is India's rank. Okay, so the countries, as you can see, that Denmark has topped in most of the indexes, parameters of this index, in sub indices, in most of the sub indices, Denmark has topped. So you can just easily memorize the countries, the different countries, the parameters in which different countries have topped. Okay, the other parameters would have Denmark at its top. And these are the India's rank, guys, in each and every parameter which you should know and remember from your exam perspective. So that was all about the Rule of Law Index. Next is the Global Food Security Index. So which country has topped in the Global Food Security Index 2021, here the right answer is Ireland. Economist Impact, which is an organization based in London, and Corteva AgriScience. So basically these two organizations have released this index. 113 countries were assessed. Ireland has topped. Burundi is at the bottom, African country here. India's rank, 71st is India's rank, 57.2 is the overall score. in affordability. So these are the parameters of this index. In affordability, India's score is 50.2. In availability, India's score is 65.7. In quality and safety, 59.1. Natural resources and resilience, 52.8. So these are the different scores and different parameters of this index of India. You have to know each and every score in different parameters of this index, because this is a very important index. And if you have covered the World Hunger Report also, so do pay attention to this thing, that these are the scores of India in terms of food security. Now, these are the parameters we have already discussed. 58 indicators were there under these parameters. Now, which South Asian country performs better than India? So Pakistan has a good score, a score which is higher than India in food affordability parameter. Okay. In Sri Lanka has a good score in food availability, but the overall rankings of both of these countries are lower than India's overall rank. Okay. China is ahead of us in the overall ranking. It is 34th in the index. Okay. So guys, that was all for today, and if you have liked the content that we have provided to you, so do not forget to subscribe our channel and share this video as much as you can. Thank you so much.